Hello everyone. I hope that you guys are doing amazing wherever you are in the world. Thank you again for listening, for subscribing, for commenting. I really appreciate the support. And in this one, I wanted to speak to you guys about a little bit of manifesting magic. Recently, a friend of mine was talking about how she's been trying to bring a little bit more manifesting into her life. To become a manifesting guru as much as possible, to become better at it in general. And one of the things that she asked for was a trip to Bali. Her and I, we live in Chiang Mai, Thailand at the moment. And one of the things she really wanted was a vacation, a trip to Bali, which isn't that expensive, but she wanted to manifest it. It was her desire, her dream, her hope. And so she tried to work upon it. So she imagined herself in Bali. She imagined herself being asked by someone to go to Bali and being given the trip as a gift and all of that. All of that you do as a manifesting person. Now, of course, there's a lot of different things related to manifesting that I'm not going to speak about in this video or in this audio. But the thing that I did want to focus on is what happens if you are given something while you're manifesting and you refuse it. Because that's exactly what happened to my girlfriend. She was trying to manifest this trip to Bali and she received it. She received a message from a friend who is in Bali and who wants her to visit him. And he offered to pay for her ticket, which wasn't that expensive. And it was just going to be a couple of days, a quick trip. And she was excited, she was exuberant, she was ecstatic. She had manifested what she wanted. Unfortunately, circumstances did not allow her to go all of a sudden. Someone was upset with her, and she had to deal with other work stuff, and something happened that caused her to say no to this gift from the universe. And the main point of contention, or the main point that she brought up for me that really made me think is that is it a negative thing? If the universe works so hard or works at giving you something beautiful, something that you wanted, something that you asked for, something that you tried to manifest with visualization and all those thought processes, and the universe actually gives it to you, and you say, no, actually, I'm not feeling it right now. So, I'm gonna pass. Does that mean that the universe is going to be upset with you, or that the universe is not gonna give you as many things as you want, or does that mean that you're not going to be able to manifest as easily? Is there a negative consequence, basically, to saying no to something that you wanted to manifest but you don't want anymore? And it's a fascinating question. I'm sure you're thinking as well, sitting there, that if I believe that the universe loves me and is a friendly place or is a friendly universe and wants to give me things, it won't be upset if it try to give me something that I wanted perhaps in the beginning, but I don't anymore, and I've said no to her, him, it. There's so many different ways of looking at it, and it's, I think, the way you view the world and the way you perceive the universe in general. There's so many different ways we can perceive the universe. You could look at it as a parent. And if it was a parent and the parent wanted to give something to the child and the child said no, a lot of times parents would get angry at it. They would think, oh, I'm working so hard. I'm trying to give you all of these beautiful things and you're saying no to me. How dare you? You don't love me. You're not a good child. I'm not going to give you anything anymore. And obviously, we've been in situations like this where we've had our parents say these things to us. And so I think if you have a perception of the universe as being such a parent, then you will think, oh, if I say no, then the universe is going to punish me. If you think of the universe as a benevolent God-like creature who is perfect and who doesn't get angry, who doesn't punish us for whatever we might do, who always loves us because we are imperfect and it knows that. And it's giving us things because it loves us. It wants to give us as much as possible, like Mother Earth does. She just gives and she gives and she gives and she gives. And she never thinks, Oh, I think I've given enough for today. I think you've had enough. I think I'm going to hold back now. And if you have a perception of the universe as such a universe, a loving universe who's forever abundant and giving, then of course you might change your mind. And yes, you wanted it yesterday, or you wanted it last week, or you wanted it a few months ago, but you've changed, you've grown, you've convoluted, you've expanded perhaps, your consciousness has changed, your needs and demands and desires have changed. So now you don't want it anymore. And so, yes, the universe is giving it to you now, but you decide, no, you know what, actually, I don't want this anymore. I want something different. So, universe, can you give me that instead? And from our perspective, we think of it, oh, we're being so petulant, we're being so selfish, and we're being so childish or immature. And how dare we do something like this? We think so much of ourselves. We think we're superior beings, or we think that we're better than we are. And we start thinking about all of these different things, exactly as my friend was thinking. But in my opinion, and this is something that I know I have to work upon as well, so I'm not saying I'm perfect at it, but I'm always trying to think of it from the universe's perspective. Why does the universe want to give us everything? Because it loves us. And it's an abundant universe and has so much, more than we can ever imagine, it has. And it wants to give us whatever we want. Whatever you could possibly imagine, the universe wants to give you that. So you ask for it. And sometimes you get it. Sometimes you don't, depending on what the universe thinks is best for you. And sometimes it gives you things and you realize that's not really what you wanted. And this has happened to me several times before, where I received something, a job in a beautiful island, or a relationship with an individual. And I actually received it, and once I received it and I worked with it, I realized I was not suitable for this job or this relationship. I realized that I had made a mistake in asking and in receiving. And of course, after that, I didn't feel bad about giving it up because I realized that the universe gave me what I wanted and it wanted me to figure it out on my own, that this is not right for me. And so once I figured that out, I rejected the offer, the job, or the relationship, and then I went on to something else. I did not think that, okay, cool, so I've already asked for something this year and I've received it. So then I guess the quota for what I'm supposed to receive is done. I'm over with, and I think the universe is not gonna give me anything, at least for this year. If you believe in quantum physics, if you believe in the time-space continuum, you know that time really doesn't exist for the universe. The time, it's not thinking, all right, so from January 1st to December 31st, I'm going to give Boom these many things, 10 things. And after 10 things, if she's asked for too much, it's over. I'm not gonna give her any more, even though it might be just the middle of the year. Time doesn't really work in that manner in the universe's perspective. It's not thinking that way. There is no time there. It's eternal. It's longer and older than we can ever imagine. And we're just here for a minuscule moment, and all it wants to do in this minuscule moment, in this micro moment, is to love us and to give us as much as we want. Some of us ask for a lot and we receive a lot. Some of us ask for a little and we receive a little. It's like that adage which says, if you go to the ocean with a cup, you will get a cup of water. If you go to the ocean with a bucket, you're gonna get a bucket of water to bring back. But if you go to the ocean with an enormous container, the entirety of your being, and you ask for that, you're gonna come back with that entire huge container of water. And the same thing applies here. The universe is an ocean of abundance, and it wants to give us as much as we want. Even if we realize or decide, yeah, I think I don't want that anymore. Thank you, universe. I really appreciate it. I'm so grateful. I'm so thankful that you decided to give this to me, but I don't think it's the right time for me. I think I've changed my mind. I know you're not going to be upset with me, obviously. Can I ask for something else? Or I'm going to ask for something else. And then you do. And I think that's how it works, or that's how I'd like to believe it works, because it has been the case for me at least, that even when I rejected the manifesting offer, even when I rejected the universe and said, I don't think I want that anymore, the universe hasn't punished me for it. It hasn't gone back on its word and says, okay, I'm not gonna give you anything anymore. It's not a petulant child. It is not an imperfect being. It is perfect and it loves perfectly with abundance and gratitude. And there is no limit to it. So we just have to believe that. We really have to inculcate that into ourselves. There is no limit to what we can receive. We just have to keep on asking and obviously giving back to the world as well. We are so lucky to be here. And I think one of the things that comes out of it is that I receive and I give in equal measures as much as possible. I hope this makes sense to you. I hope I was able to explain myself to you. If you have any questions, please do comment below. And I shall see you the next time around. Bye for now.